once in a while we talk about some of the hideous crimes against women in countries like Afghanistan, right? And Pakistan, where a man will literally throw acid on a woman's face if she brings shame to him or his family. Well, there's a GOP spokesman who is advocating for the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is a man by the name of Jay Townsend. He's actually a spokesperson for a freshman representative by the name of Nan Hayworth in New York. And apparently he got into a little bit of a tiff on a forum online. And apparently he told a constituent who was asking about gas prices to, quote, "Listen to Tom, what a little bee he has in his bonnet, buzz buzz. My question today, when is Tommy Boy going to weigh in on all the Lilly Ledbetter hypocrites who claim to be fighting the war on women? Let's hurl some acid at those female Democratic senators who don't abide the mandates they want to impose on the private sector."
And he's a professional at this. He's actually been trained at online communication. Here's the first mistake that he made. It says that he engaged in a vicious online rant as a spokesman. Avoid online rants. If you're Penn Gillette, they can work out pretty well, but aside from Gillette, that's it.
Right, and also, you are a spokesperson for a representative in New York, okay? Your job is to not get into a public rant against a constituent. If anything, you want to avoid that more than anything at all. And by the way, what I find very interesting is that Townsend maintains a Facebook page called How to Run for Public Office.
Yeah.
Not exactly the best person to give you advice on how to run for public office. Now, the fascinating part about this story is that Representative Hayworth has still not fired him.
Yeah.
That would be the first thing I'd do. I'm like, you are a moron.
Well, he's a Republican.
I want these constituents to vote for me.
If this had been a spokesperson for Barack Obama, how fast would this person have been thrown on the bus?
Oh, it would take 2 seconds.
Now, look, this is just a spokesperson for a relatively low-level Republican. You know, he's not very high up in the party or anything like that, so we can't hold him up as too much of an example for what Republicans think, but it's been pretty common in the last few years, especially as the more religiously devout sectors of the Republican Party have come to prominence, that they believe some of the same things as, you know, religious sects in, like, say, the Taliban, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
They have some of the same beliefs in regards to treatment of women, homosexuals, things like that. But when we make this comparison as liberals, people might say we're being too extreme, you know, they don't really believe the same thing. But I like that this person has made the comparison so much easier to make by bringing up the idea of throwing acid in the face.
Also, what's very ironic, and Cenk yesterday talked about how some conservatives are born without the irony gene, right? And this is a perfect example of that. Because as you are denying a war on women, you're advocating throwing acid on women's faces.
Mm-hmm.
Congratulations.
Yeah. just one woman, though. So maybe it doesn't qualify.
Well, okay. I mean, let's make this at least clarification. It was based in an analogy because it said they're throwing aspersions at people about the war on women. They're throwing this war on women at them. Throw some acid on their face. It was the worst choice of words. But I want to make sure it doesn't seem like he's saying go get yourself a cup of acid and start slinging it at them, which is what crazy people will do when they hear that statement. Yes.
To be fair,
it's a bad choice of words because you're talking to insane people.
To be fair to him, I don't think he was being literal. But you're totally right. People who already have in their heads, because they watch the garbage on Fox News, that liberals are the bad guys. We got to go after them. Look at all these baby killers. Look at all these horrible people who are pro-abortion. Let's go after them, right? Those are the kinds of people who will read statements like that, and they'll say, yeah, we need to grab some acid and throw them on their faces. I mean, look, how many stories have we done about Planned Parenthood clinics or even just women's health clinics that have been firebombed, that have been put on fire? Those kinds of stories infuriate me, not only because we don't cover them at all. It's never in the mainstream media. It's barely getting any media coverage, but also because it's something that is almost acceptable in society. Like, oh, it turns out that another Planned Parenthood clinic got firebombed. Moving on. No, let's focus on the root of the problem. And the root of the problem is when people make statements like this.
Yeah, look, I understand that Jared's just playing devil's advocate, basically. But it would be one thing if he said, let's throw some trash on her. Let's do something like that. But hurl acid only means one thing. And it already comes equipped with the reference to women. It's always women that get acid thrown in their face around the world. So either this person is incredibly ignorant and has no knowledge of the cultural practices around the globe.
I think that's likely.
But why would they even think of acid in that case?
I don't know. I don't know why I'm giving this guy the benefit of the doubt. I really don't think he was being literal. Do you think he was being literal in this case?
I think that he was trying to use that image. I don't think that he wants actual acid to be thrown physically in the face of anyone, but I think that he was trying to conjure up that particular image, which is either ignorant or incredibly offensive to people who don't want acid thrown in the face of women.
Yeah.
Which is most people, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. This guy is just hideous. By the way, how come O'Reilly's not talking about him on the show? You know, O'Reilly will like take one statement, will take like Hillary Rosen's statement and blow it out of proportion. But then you have a spokesperson for a Republican representative. I don't care if it's a freshman representative, right? They'll make a statement like this and Bill O'Reilly's like, doo, 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 doo. Let's talk about Hillary Rosen and a statement that was taken out of context.